Hi, everybody. Welcome once again to Candlepin Bowling. I'm Don Gillis, and you know by now this program is on videotape, and we do our taping sometimes several weeks before you see the telecast right here at Sammy White's Brighton Bowl. It's always three strings of candlepin bowling, and it is always the total pin ball which determines our winner, who is rewarded with a handsome marble-based trophy from the Ace Trophy Company of Boston. The runner-up receives a smaller but otherwise identical version indicating he was a participant on our show. And in between both, you see the digital clock radio, which will go to our Yellow Pages Marksman of the Day, the bowler with the most marks. $700 goes to the winner, $300 goes to the runner-up. We have guaranteed prize money of at least $1,000. The other opportunities for our bowlers to get a little richer. For a 400 series, an extra bonus of $100. For three marks in a row, that's any combination of strikes or spares in the same string, $50 in bonus money, and then each subsequent consecutive mark in that same string, as long as he can keep it going, would be worth $50 each. For three strikes in a row, there's an additional bonus of $1,000, and for a subsequent consecutive strike, in other words, four in a row, which has happened just once, there would be $2,000 in bonus. Now, we also have a high-low jackpot. That is now worth $1,175, and if neither bowler hits that today, then we'll be shooting for $1,200 and so on until somebody hits whatever has accumulated in that high-low jackpot. All right, we'll get underway with the first match today, right after this. It's league average 120, high single 200, high triple 466. Nope, no mark in the first box. All right, maybe I gave you those stats a little too fast. I know some of you like to keep them. His average is 120. Good 10. His high single, 200. His high 3, 466. And he won his roll off with a 654. Phil is a design draftsman for Warren Pumps. He's married, has three children. He's representing the Monson Lanes. Eight. Our defending champion on for the third consecutive week, Geoff Heavner, Ashland, a self-employed builder with four children and a couple of grandchildren. Goff's average 118. High single 189. High triple 438. 658 in winning his roll off. One of those go down. Nope. Ralph Stewart calls time. There is a pin which is loose and could possibly be touching the deadwood line. It is, and it is removed. Bowler rolling 18 in the first two frames. I neglected to mention at the start that the runner-up today will also receive a certificate for a Fisher Space Pen, the only ball pen used on all Apollo and Soyuz flights. Big hit. He made it. Home viewer jackpot worth $300 at the conclusion of today's show. High-low jackpot worth $1,175. So we could be giving away a pretty good hunk of change today. And depending upon how these bowlers do, bonus-wise, might be a real big hunk. Oh, wasn't that nice to see that nine go down? So he has the four horsemen to work on without having to worry about that back pin. Got it that time and probably has some second thoughts about whether he should have gone for the 1-2 pocket or gone for the 1-3 pocket. Geoff Heavner. Genuine spare lead. Spare in the fourth. And right now we will pause. Catch you up to date on the score at the end of four. Our defending champion, Geoff Heavner of Ashland, 37 with a bonus ball to roll. Our challenger, Phil Clough of Warren, Massachusetts, 44. Opening string, today's challenger. Almost a spread eagle. This can go, depends upon what he can do with that number three pin. Like that. He hit it perfectly at the right side of the number three and kicked it over, and it took down the four and the seven. Perfect way to play it. Now, Geoff Heavner is working on that spare you see up there in the fourth, so this is the bonus ball. Too bad, just four. Spread eagle. He was trying to do a similar thing, but he was too full on the number three. Go to the left side now. Nice out. Nice out, considering that he only got one on the right side. You only have five more days to pick up your entry blank with the opportunity of winning a brand new Chevette. 1983 Chevette. Nope. Because Channel 5, WCBB-TV, and the Massachusetts Bowling Association teaming up to offer you the biggest, most exciting home viewer contest ever to help us celebrate our 25th anniversary, our silver anniversary of Candlepin Bowling on at 12 noon on Channel 5 for 25 successive years. And that show is going to be on October 8th. However, the entries will close for the automobile on September 15th. Phil Clough this three. That's all he got for a fill. All right, to enter, you just go to your nearest Massachusetts Bowling Association lane and pick up an entry form. Fill it out and mail it by September 15th, 1983. Licensed drivers only, and only one entry per person. Employees of Channel 5 and Massachusetts Bowling Association members and employees are not eligible. Big hit for Phil. That's too bad to miss that one. Missing it twice. Geoff Heavner coming up. I have one of those entry forms for the Chevy Chevette right in front of me now. And it's pretty simple to fill out. We'll watch, see what happens here. Oh, no. But there's a little place for your name, address, telephone number, and then I certify I am a licensed driver and not an employee of WCVB or any Massachusetts Bowling Association center, and then a place for your signature. That's it. The drawing is going to be September 20th at 1 p.m. at Boston's Waterfront Park, and the anniversary show will be on October the 8th. $7. Phil Clough, today's challenger. Again, Phil's average is 120. And defending champion Geoff Heavner's is 118. $10, 91. Oh, big strike in the 10th frame. He's at 101. Seven on the first. 108. 109. Now Geoff Heavner. Geoff trailing in completed frames by 5. Thank you. 84. Needs a mark to get out of the 90s. Half Worcester left. Nice 10. 94. So he trails by 15. And that's unusual for him in the previous two shows, which he won. The score at the end of the first string, challenger Phil Clough of Warren, 109. Defending champion Geoff Heavner of Ashland, 94. As you know, always leads off the middle string. Grows second in the first and third. Just two pins standing, but they're a tough pair, the 9 and 10. He's going to have to put the ball just enough to touch the 9 and also get the pin to go into the 10. Oh, no, too far to the right. Missed the 9. He had to do it with the ball if he was going to get the 9. I was just looking at the large card that they have up in every Massachusetts Bowling Association lane about, you know, where you can pick up your entry blanks for the car. And there's a picture of me on it, and I'm surprised I can see an awful lot more of my forehead there than I used to. Seems to be pictures I used to have taken. My hair came down a little further on the forehead. Ah, well. 9. Okay, this is Phil Clough, today's challenger. Ooh, if that had come this way, we might have seen a backdoor strike. Nice shot. Phil Clough starts off the second string with a spare. Six. All right, he had the four horsemen in the first string. He took out the 2, the 4, and the 7 and left the 1. Let's see what he does this time. Same thing. So Phil Clough is adding to his lead, has added another 7 pins to the 15 that he had. 22 pin lead over this man, Geoff Heavner, our defending champion. Tough split. Seven. Now, challenger Phil Clough has a chance to add even further to that lead of 22 pins. Boy, he got a break there. Yes. Spare opposite a 10. Thin hit. Just 4. Six in the frame, and we're going to pause once again. Phil Clough leads the match by 25 pins. He came in leading by 15, and he has added 10 more. So at the end of 4, it's Phil Clough, 46, Geoff Heavner, 36. Middle string, trailing in the match by 25 pins. There's a big hit. That's only his second mark. He's won 2 in a row, beating John Zernike, 349, 348. And last week, defeating Bill Trefo, 337, 329. And he did that in the final frame. He needed a 10 to tie, and he got a spare with an 8 on it. Just 7. Challenger Phil Clough. C-L-O-U-G-H. Drop a little here with 19 pins as opposed to the 24 which were picked up by Geoff Heavner in his spare 6 and the 7. Giglio keeping score on the big scoreboard today, and Frank Galazzi keeping score beside me. Geoff Heavner, 2 full on the head pin that time. Ralph Stewart, as usual, our lob line judge and referee, sitting right there on the lob line. Joanne Panto is our statistician and secretary, and the man who puts it all together and has all the headaches as producer and director, Phil Rubin. Geoff having some difficulties now. Phil Clough comes up. C-L-O-U-G-H. As in rough or tough. Spare leave. You got it. Clear. Pretty good hit. Oh, yeah. Big nine. So Phil Clough is really adding to his lead. And he has a 10-pin to pick up with wood up against it, which he still should get it. Just barely. Oh, baby, that was close. Now Geoff Heavner coming up. I was thinking about that sound, O-U-G-H, in Clough and rough and tough. And I've often thought of how difficult it must be for someone trying to learn English when you tell them that O-U-G-H is up, as in tough and rough, and then they see it in B-O-U-G-H, and you tell them that's bow, and then you see it in C-O-U-G-H, and you tell them that's cough. Nice shot! And I have one more, and then you give them T-H-R-O-U-G-H, and you say that's through. A little confusing. Okay, here is Geoff Heavner. Five. Too bad. Oh, pretty shot. Just a nine. 97. Now, Phil Clough is already at 94, plus what he gets on this next one, and he's hoping for some bonus money. He has two marks in a row. Seven. He got it. $50 in bonus money. It's still alive, the bonus money. Four horsemen right side. See if he has better luck getting it on the right side. Yes, he got it. $100 in bonus money, and it's still alive. If he throws a strike now, he gets another 50. All right, Phil Clough waiting for the pin setter right now. Nope, but he got seven more. 134, fine string for Phil Clough. And he is way ahead right now going into the third string. The totals, which Algilio has just placed upon the board, indicate that at the end of two, challenger Phil Clough of Warren leads defending champion Geoff Heavner of Ashland 243 to 191. He's up by 52 pins. Another mark. League average 120, and he's already rolled better than his average for the first two strings. Just five, and a strange looking five. It sort of cleaned out the middle. Seven. Geoff Heavner, who came from behind last week, He needed 10 to tie. And he not only did he get the 10 because he spared in the last frame, but also got 8 more. Next week's challenger will be a man who hasn't been on for 10 years, but he's one of our good bowlers from out of the past, Jim Barber. Doesn't seem possible that it's been 10 years since he's been on. I have seen him since then, of course, at either the Massachusetts Bowling Association Awards Banquet or the World Candlepin Bowling Congress Awards Banquet, or sometimes he's been here just to root somebody else on. Big strike for Phil Clough. Phil has $100 in bonus money. Got that in that middle string. Nope. That one got away. As soon as he let it go, he knew that it wasn't going to go anywhere near the head pin. Eight it is. Geoff Heavner coming up. At the conclusion of our show, we will have our high-low jackpot worth $1,175 and our home viewer jackpot worth $300. Oh, there was a big break. Instead of having the diamond, he has the nine pin alone and wood in front of it. For Geoff Heavner. Wouldn't mind seeing somebody hit that $300 today, because then we will empty out that plexiglass barrel, which is right now so full I can hardly turn it. Too bad. Just three. Pretty shot. In the event that there might be somebody out there who doesn't know what I'm talking about with that home viewer jackpot, what we've asked folks to do is to submit on a postcard. Postcard only, not a letter. We won't accept letters for this. If you want to write a letter to Phil or me about something else, that's fine, but not for the home viewer jackpot. On a postcard only, guess what you think the total pinfall will be, both bowlers combined. Obviously, for example, if they both rolled, if somebody rolled a 351 and the other one rolled a 349, it would total out to 700. And then we would ask you to make a guess at what you think the total pinfall will be on a day when your card might be chosen. And we'll give you 10 pins either side. If you're within 10 either way, either 690 or 710 in the event that it might turn out to be 700. But it's one card per person per day. That's all we allow. And then after someone hits, then we just clean out that big barrel. And the stage managers get a big kick out of doing that. They love it. We add $50 to the jackpot every single week until somebody walks away with whatever is accumulated, and then we start all over again at $50. But if your card is chosen, even if you don't have the right guess as to the total pinfall, you'll receive at least a couple of prizes. just send it along to Candlepin Bowling, WCVB-TV, 5 TV Place, Needham, Massachusetts, zip code number 02192. Acted like the diamond, didn't it? There were four pins not in the diamond shape. Well, maybe a diamond, but a different kind. Sort of. 1-5 and 2-8. Only a fantastic, unbelievable finish by Geoff Heavner in the final four frames will keep Phil Clough from winning this one. Geoff Heavner coming up for his 7th and 8th in the 3rd string. Remember, our big silver anniversary show will be on October 8th. So we'll have 3 more shows before it. The next one will be next Saturday when Jim Barber will be the challenger. Spare for Geoff Heavner. He can get both of these, the 7 and the 8, if he hits that wood just right near the end. Oh, he didn't get the wood. Had to get the wood, as it was set up for him. Like that. Final two for Phil Clough. He leads the match at the moment by 53 pins. And then he adds a strike. First bonus ball. Amazing. Gee. He really deserved that one. So he gets a 10 instead, makes it 115, and he winds up with a total of 368. And Geoff Heavner right now is in danger of not rolling a 300. Thank you. that seven had gone down now. He's got his 300, just barely. Nine it is. 302, and congratulations from Geoff Heavner to our new champion, Phil Clough. Remember now, we're going for a high-low jackpot of $1,175 and a home viewer jackpot of $300, which we'll get to right after we give you the final score. Phil Clough, our new champion, 358. Our runner-up today, Geoff Heavner, 302. And I also told you that we're going to be giving away a brand new automobile. And in that time, I was talking about what you can see in your nearest Massachusetts Bowling Association lane is this thing, and then you'll see all these entry blank things over here. That's also what I was talking about, that picture, when I said I had a little more forehead than I had remembered. Well, anyway, this is what you'll see, Silver Anniversary Home Viewer Jackpot. And what it is the entry blank that if you send it in, remember, only a few more days left now. We're going to September the 15th, and here already we are at the 10th. It's Channel 5, it says right here, clearly, Channel 5 and the Massachusetts Bowling Association are teaming up to offer you the biggest and most exciting home viewer contest ever to help celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Candlepin Bowling Show. And we're proud of the fact, you know, that we've been on the air now consecutively for 25 years at 12 noon, Channel 5. And one lucky home viewer is going to drive away from the anniversary show in a brand new Chevette. See a picture of it down here. It's a brand new 1983 Chevette four-door hatchback, silver, with natural leaf, silver anniversary, of course, right? With four-cylinder engine, four-speed transmission, reclining front bucket seats, console, white wall tires, and more. The manufacturer's suggested retail price of the anniversary car is $5,906, tax, title, and registration fees not included. Now, the only thing that we say, you get one of these entry blanks and you send it in. You've got to send it in by September 15th. And it's licensed drivers only, and only one entry per person. And employees of WCVB and the Massachusetts Bowling Association employees are not eligible. So do it, will you please? I mean, just till next Thursday, you know, you don't want to miss out on an opportunity. Okay, one other thing we have to do here is take care of the home viewer. And again, we don't have a very big total. It's the combined total, as you know, that all these are people are guessing at. And today's total is just 660 between the two bowlers, so that's one of the lower ones. So it's probable that we maybe won't have anybody guess exactly that or within 10 either way. However, when I reached in there and pull a card, that person is at least going to be rewarded with these prizes.
A checkbook calculator from Canon. A handheld 8-digit model with 3-color-coded independent memories, complete with case. And a Penguin Dress Lighter, a compact gold-tone design with butane operation in a rib case. And a Schaefer writing instrument. For over 75 years, Schaefer writing instruments have set world standards for quality, precision, and beauty. Schaefer fountain ballpoint pens and pencils, truly jewelry for writing.
The odds are going to be kind of tough, aren't they, huh, when you see all of these cards that I have to go through. But remember, when we do get a winner, then we will empty it out and we'll be starting with a brand new bunch. All right, let's find out if anybody is within 10 pins either way from 650 to 670 today. I don't think we're going to have a winner. I don't think so. I want to get one not too far from the top, okay? Let's take a guess on this one. And, oh, you won't believe this. Okay, John J. McCormick, Oxford Circle, Belmont, Massachusetts, is not a winner. However, he has guessed 639. How about that? How about that? All right, so we are going to add another $50, and next week it will be worth $350. Okay, Phil Clough, if you knock down the 1710 with one ball, you go home $1,175 richer. So pick a lane and fire away. Okay, Goff, it's still there. Okay, gentlemen, would you come up here, please, Goff? Phil, just face toward the camera there so they can see you. We don't care about seeing me. They've seen enough of me. Well, Goff, you knew that eventually it was going to happen,
right.
Didn't you, huh?
Yeah.
But you
lost it.
Well, I tell you, listen, not too many folks, as you know, come on here for the very first time. You and Phil have done it, coming on for the first time. I think it's tougher to repeat, as you did. And so you have the satisfaction of knowing that you not only won, but you also repeated. And you have two larger trophies, and then you get one of these smaller ones. You also got $300. No bonus money. I can't find any bonus money here. But you have a certificate here for a Fisher Space Pen, the only ball pen used on all Apollo and Soyuz flights. And that can be used when you're making an estimate for somebody on their contract.
Thank
you. It's a pleasure to see you and your children and grandchildren rooting for you.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoy it. Come back and see us again. Okay, Phil, you did it, as I just said. You came on for the first time. Were you nervous?
Oh, very.
Were you?
Oh,
you
yeah.
You didn't show it. No, you didn't show it.
You didn't hear my knees knocking?
No. When did it start to come together a little bit? When you started to hit the middle string?
When I got the four in a row.
It
came a little easier then.
Oh, what a lovely feeling that was, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, to get the three and then to add to it. And it made it so much nicer. Well, let's see. You are also our Yellow Pages March of the Day, so it looks like you're getting just about everything here, including bonus money. This one goes up on the shelf, and nobody can ever take it away from you. It shows you were a winner on our show. And with that, of course, goes $700. And those four marks in a row is worth another $100, so $800. And you are also our Yellow Pages Marksman of the Day. And that's a very nice little thing to have next to your bed to be sure that you get to work on time at Warren Pumps.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to be challenged by a guy who used to be one of our better bowlers, hasn't been on for a while, 10 years, in fact. But I'm sure if you've watched the show, you've seen Jim Barber.
He's heard the name.
Okay, fine. We'll see you next week. God get us for the whole crew. It'll be Jim Barber challenging our new champion, Phil Clough, on Candlepin Bowling next Saturday, same time, same station. Bye-bye.